This is the Salford home of Benham Farzana Bagbanen, a people trafficker whose gang exploited hundreds of Iranians with promises of safe passage to the UK.
They were a ruthless gang who exploited migrants for money. They offered an end-to-end pipeline from Iran through safe European countries to the United Kingdom.
Our cameras joined immigration officers on Operation Cozy back in 2016, when Farzana Bagbanen's house was first raided. Inside, they found mobile phones, passports and bank cards used to book flights for undocumented asylum seekers. Farzana Bagbanen was arrested but fled the country just days later, and it wasn't until March 2019 that he was extradited back to the UK to face the criminal justice system. Between January 2015 and December 2016, Benham Farzana Bagbanen and his gang were involved in around 260 attempts to reach the UK. Iranian nationals paid thousands for false documents which would enable them to board a flight. But once in the air, those documents would be destroyed. When they landed at airports like Manchester, they tried to claim asylum, but around half never actually made it through.
They were paying for a premium service. They were paying around £12,000. And the crime group would go to great lengths to try and match fake documents to their appearance and give them hints and tips around how to act more Western. And in some cases, they offered a sort of no arrival guarantee. So if they were stopped by foreign law enforcement from boarding the plane, they were then given a second and third attempt to reach the UK.
They'd send pictures of the shirts and shoes they hoped would give them the best chance of getting through airport security. And whether they made it or not, Farzana Bagbanen and his gang still pocketed at least £170,000. Once caught, he confessed to a criminal business described by the judge as a travel agency for the desperate. His associates Kaveh Sharafat, Machaba Salehi and Mohammed Nadiri were given suspended sentences for money laundering. And their ringleader, a man who sought asylum himself when he arrived in the UK, will now spend the next 8.5 years behind bars. Amy Welch, ITV News.